Bonjour tout le monde. Hello everyone. I am happy to be here at House in Toronto with Minister Ng, Greg Fergus, the chair of the Parliamentary Black Caucus, and Adam Vaughan and Gary Ananda Sangari. I also want to thank one of the co-founders of House, Ahmed Ismail, for welcoming us today. I know that Abel Tesfaye, known as The Weeknd, and Lamar Taylor are also co-founders of House and wanted to be here but just couldn't make it, so thanks to them as well. We're also joined by members of the local community and representatives from some of Canada's largest banks. Over the last 6 months, as our country faced the unprecedented challenge of COVID-19, we've seen that there exists still far too many gaps in our society. For Black entrepreneurs, this pandemic has highlighted the many inequalities they face. We need an economic recovery that's inclusive and equitable for all Canadians. Earlier today, I talked with some local Black entrepreneurs about what starting a business means to them and what the last few months have been like. They told me what it was like to build the company of their dreams and the importance of giving back to the community. The small businesses that Black entrepreneurs create are the backbone of our communities. Just take the story of Thornton and Lucy Blackburn, two prominent Black Canadian entrepreneurs from the early 1800s. After the Blackburns escaped from slavery, they became successful business owners, starting Toronto's very first taxi company. Here in Toronto, at the end of the Underground Railroad, the Blackburns brought a new dream to life, a dream of building economic freedom through hard work, perseverance, and hope, a dream that gave them pride in creating something with their own two hands and contributing to their community and their city. They achieved that dream, all the while reaching back to help others move forward. Their legacy speaks to what Black business owners have always done and still do for their communities. From the Blackburns to Viola Desmond, Black business owners are at the very centre of their communities. To Black entrepreneurs, we heard you when you said that investing in the right tools and support create good, sustainable jobs. You're absolutely right. An investment in Black excellence is an investment in economic empowerment. And economic empowerment is an essential part of justice. It's justice against a system that has locked out far too many Black entrepreneurs and denied them the same opportunities as other Canadians. So today, we're taking another step forward to reduce barriers and address that. This morning, I can announce that the Government of Canada, in partnership with Canadian banks, is investing nearly $221 million to launch Canada's first ever Black entrepreneurship program. The Government of Canada's share will be nearly $93 million over 4 years as part of this program. The Black Entrepreneurship Program will help thousands of Black business owners through our economic recovery and into the months and years ahead. I'd like to take a moment to thank our partners for working with us to address an issue Black Canadians have faced for far too long. The Black Entrepreneurship Program will include funding to support three new initiatives: a National Ecosystem Fund, a Black Entrepreneurship Loan Fund, and a Black Entrepreneurship Knowledge Hub. Let me start with the National Ecosystem Fund. Black business owners and entrepreneurs often have a hard time getting the right tools and mentorship to succeed. With this new National Ecosystem Fund, Black entrepreneurs will have access to financial planning services and business training they need for the months and years to come. Black entrepreneurs also continue to face systemic barriers when it comes to accessing loans from financial institutions. That's what the second part of our program, the Black Entrepreneurship Loan Fund, will tackle. With this new fund, Black businesses will be eligible for loans of up to $250,000. And that brings me to the third part of this program, the creation of a new Black Entrepreneurship Knowledge Hub. To build back better, we need the best data possible to ensure future funding is more efficient. This hub will identify the barriers standing in the way of Black entrepreneurs and highlight opportunities for future growth. To get the right input from communities, the hub will be run by Black-led business organizations in partnership with universities and colleges. Moving forward, Statistics Canada will continue to collect disaggregated data to better understand the needs of Black entrepreneurs. Aujourd'hui, j'annonce que le gouvernement du Canada, en partenariat avec plusieurs banques canadiennes, investira jusqu'à 221 millions de dollars afin de lancer le tout premier programme pour l'entrepreneuriat des communautés noires. La contribution du gouvernement du Canada pour ce programme s'élève à près de 93 millions de dollars sur 4 ans. Ce programme prévoit le financement de 3 nouvelles initiatives, le Fonds pour l'écosystème national, le Fonds de prêt pour l'entrepreneuriat des communautés noires et le Carrefour du savoir pour l'entrepreneuriat des communautés noires. J'aimerais d'abord vous parler du Fonds pour l'écosystème national. Ce programme aidera des milliers de propriétaires d'entreprises et d'entrepreneurs noirs durant notre reprise économique et au cours des mois qui viennent. Je tiens à prendre un instant pour remercier nos partenaires de travailler avec nous afin de régler des problèmes auxquels les Canadiens noirs font face depuis bien trop longtemps. Ce programme prévoit le financement de 3 nouvelles initiatives, le Fonds pour l'écosystème national, le Fonds de prêt pour l'entrepreneuriat des communautés noires et le Carrefour du savoir pour l'entrepreneuriat des communautés noires. J'aimerais d'abord vous parler du Fonds pour l'écosystème national. Les propriétaires d'entreprises et les entrepreneurs noirs ont souvent de la difficulté à obtenir les outils et le mentorat dont ils ont besoin pour réussir. Par l'entremise de ce fonds, ces entrepreneurs auront accès à des services de planification financière et de formation commerciale afin d'être en meilleure position pendant qu'on rebâtit notre économie. Historiquement, les entrepreneurs noirs font également face à des obstacles systémiques quand ils souhaitent obtenir des prêts d'institutions financières. C'est pourquoi nous mettons sur pied le deuxième volet de notre programme, le Fonds de prêt pour l'entrepreneuriat des communautés noires. Grâce à ce nouveau fonds, les entreprises appartenant à des entrepreneurs noirs seront en mesure d'obtenir des prêts pouvant atteindre 250 000 $. Et cela m'amène au troisième volet de ce programme, la création d'un nouveau carrefour du savoir pour l'entrepreneuriat des communautés noires. Si nous voulons rebâtir en mieux, nous devons avoir les meilleures données possibles afin de veiller à ce que le financement futur soit plus efficace. Ce carrefour servira à cerner les obstacles qui nuisent à la réussite des entrepreneurs noirs et à mettre en évidence les possibilités de croissance future. Pour qu'on soit certain d'obtenir des renseignements exacts de la part des communautés, le carrefour sera géré par des organisations communautaires et commerciales dirigées par des Noirs, en partenariat avec des universités et des collèges. À l'avenir, Statistique Canada va continuer de faire la collecte de données désagrégées afin de mieux comprendre les difficultés et les besoins des entrepreneurs noirs. Cette annonce vise à créer un investissement à long terme dans nos communautés et à aider les gens d'atteindre leur plein potentiel. The Black Entrepreneurship Program wouldn't be possible without the leadership of Black business organizations. I'd like to thank them again for their hard work on building this new program with us. This funding is another step in supporting the hopes and aspirations of Black Canadians, and it's another step towards our commitment to address the systemic racism that affects Black communities. We know there's still more work to be done, and we're committed to doing that work. In the weeks and months to come, our government will continue to stand with all Canadians through this economic recovery. We will continue to build a better, more equitable, more inclusive Canada where everyone has a real and fair chance at success. Notre gouvernement comprend que notre population constitue notre plus grand atout.